Hi, this is Philip from IC Trainer, and today we talk a little bit about the most important value for your cycling training, the FTP, Functional Threshold Power, and how you find out your personal value. While we are talking about all of this, this is that we want to bring you in the position to do effective training. So it's very important that every training session is done in with the correct intensity. Otherwise, your training is not effective, and so it's very important that you set the right training impulses always. The easiest way to determine the training intensity is the perceived exertion. There's a Borg scala with some orientation values. For this, we have inactive and light exertion and so on until maximum. But the disadvantage to use this for your to control your training intensity is that you as an athlete must constantly recontrol your intensity through the perceived exertion. This is not useful for an effective training management, especially if a coach is setting up your training. So another possibility is to use the heart rate as the orientation value. This is possible today because you have a lot of smartwatches with the heart rate measurement, and there are training areas with a percentage dependency to your own maximum max heart rate. Between 50 and 60% of your maximum heart rate, you're in the health zone. Then there's coming the fat burning, the basic endurance, BE1 zone. Then we have the aerobic zone, basic endurance, BE2. Then there is the anaerobic zone, the development zone, DSAT. This one, the aerobic zone, is little bit tempo, and this anaerobic zone, this is much more tempo, but you can't do it so long. Then there's the danger zone. This is only for very short intervals and the maximum heart rate. But the heart rate is only a reaction to the intensity. So it takes a while until the heart rate reacts after changes. And also the power heart rate ratio is very individual. So this means it's a very important way value for the training result evaluation, but not to control the intensity. Also, it's very useful to use the heart rate to check your current recovery state to plan the next training sessions. Not to overexcite, but to recover at the right moment. In meantime, there's another possibility to set training intensity on your bike, and that's the watt-based training. This is also possible because the technology is very cheap in meantime, and it's very simple to assemble the pedals, for example, to get the watt value and send them to your computer. Similar to the heart-based training, we have the following levels. And these are calculated in as percent from your personal FTP value. So below 55%, you're in the active recovery level in the compensation. Then there's the endurance level, and then the tempo level. So endurance you can do very long. Tempo is for mid-long distances. Then there's the lactate threshold level. Then the VO2 max level. The anaerobic capacity, this is for sprints and for very short sprints, the neuromuscular power level. And so, and why we have values higher than 100%? This is because the FTP, the Functional Threshold Power value, is the value you can reach in a well-balanced 1 hour, 1 hour time trial in average. And for sure, the power you can ride 1 hour is lower as the power you can produce in a short sprint. And An effective training program is a good mixture for these categories in line to your personal goals. A sprinter has to train much more often in the neuromuscular power level as an Ironman triathlete who has to train more the endurance because he has only well-balanced exertions. Let's step a little bit deeper into the issue of training by intensity. This means in a good training, you set training stimuli. So you train normally with several intervals with different durations and intensity. For example, here we see that the green levels are the recovery levels, and then you have yellow, orange, and red, the levels with a higher intensity, so a higher resistance, and this is the training stimuli we use. So you can write, for example, 10 minutes with 60% of your FTP value, of your personal FTP value, then you write 4 minutes with 70%, then 80%, 90%, whatever. And you can do it also that you write a ramp, that you have your recovery phases, and then you between them you increase the resistance more and more and go then back to a recovery phase. These are examples for interval training. And if you train on a turbo trainer, this VET value is set as a target value, or is sent as a target value to your turbo trainer. And the turbo trainer is automatically setting the needed resistance for this. Also, if you change the cadence, so this is called ERG mode, and if you're doing a higher cadence, then the resistance is adjusted from the turbo trainer itself. This is very helpful for your training. So it's also very easy, for example, to do a HIIT training where you ride very short but very hard intervals. For example, this here is a 30-second interval, but with a very high intensity, with a very high resistance. In between, you have a recovery phase again, also only 30 seconds. And so your turbo trainer is setting this resistance every time. And yeah, you can follow the program then. That's a very effective training because you can do, you can reach a very good effect in a short time, and time is very often a limitation we are forced with. Later, we will show you an additional test protocol with for advanced rider with a little bit more possibilities. So FTP in IC trainer. So you can input your personal FTP value in the rider dialog. That's very simple. Or you can start the FTP test and the tool is calculating then the value for you and adds it automatically there. So you have to click Open FTP Test on the wizard tab and select then one of the test protocols. And for the first time, we suggest to use the ramp test. So you process the test after clicking the play button. You can get also additional information for the test if you click the info button there, and you stop the training yourself if you run the ramp test, if you are done, if nothing is, if you can't reach the resistance again. So we suggest to have support on your side as you have to push to your limits. For the other tests, you have to add the estimated FTP value first for allow the program to set the resistance for the exertion segments here. And then you have to control the VET resistance manually with the plus minus buttons to add more resistance or to ride a little bit with less resistance. So we have also integrated an FTP test for advanced rider in our tool. The reason is that the pure FTP test is focused only on endurance, and so you get no info about your individual strengths and weaknesses. And so the training resistance, especially for short intervals, is inaccurate only. And so this is the test protocol. It's also published from the German tour magazine as a do-it-your-own power test. And here we see we have an 8-second, a 1-minute sprint, and we have a 5-minute and a 20-minute exertion. So it's a very hard test protocol, but we have more information about the different areas. And so we can calculate now not only the pure FTP value, but also the value for the critical power, the anaerobic capacity, the AVC, and an assumption about the maximum oxygen uptake, VO2 max. So you can see these values in the BPM watt dialog. Here we have this example. And now we can see we have, this is the 5-second sprint value, the 1-minute sprint value you reached, then the 5-minute exertion watt value you reached, and then the 20 minutes. And now you can see, especially for these two areas, training areas, these values are calculated based off the results they have reached for these two intervals. So it's much more accurate. So it's a more fine adjustment for the short training areas, for the short intervals. And so your training is more oriented on your personal strength. And, these values are also important for your objective target. So if you are a long distance rider, you want to reach a high FTP value, that's all, fine. If you are a climber, you want to reach a high FTP value per kilogram you have to move. If you're a sprinter, then you need a high FTP because you need to reach the sprint line, but also high AWC value for good sprint result. And it's totally different in time trial. You need a high FTP, but AWC value can be low. That's fine because it's more endurance issue we have to train for. And so the right mix of training is oriented on your target. And so it's very important that we integrate also more information about your sprint capacity. Some additional hints, for example, the sitting position. You should write your FTP test in your favorite sitting position. The reason is you can reach higher values if you're sitting upright, but you have the aerodynamic is worse in this case. And so to have the correct value for road cyclist or triathlete, it's important to use your normal position, because else it's not comparable if you train outside. And for example, it could be that you are faster in the real world with a less watt result, but with a better sitting position because there's more or there's less aerodynamic resistance. There can be a difference between 30 watt, so you have the same speed with the 30 watt less, but in a better position. For beginners, you should do the FTP test in an upright sitting position. That's fine. So then, maximum heart rate. If you want to determine the maximum heart rate, you should better use a running test because then your upper body is more active. If you're right on your bike, in the best case, the upper body is doing nothing. So you do a warm-up for 10 minutes, and then within the next 10 minutes, you increase the speed step by step. And in the last minute, then you run with the maximum speed you sprint. And then at the end of this test, you reach the maximum heart rate normally. Now we want to talk a little bit about our tool we are using for our training. That's IC Trainer, Indoor Cycling Trainer. That's the perfect tool for all cyclists and triathletes for anything but boring indoor cycling training. It's a cheap alternative to other apps in the market. It's available for the relevant OS systems as Windows, Android, iOS, and macOS. It's compatible with the most Bluetooth enabled turbo trainers. Examples are Elite or Tux Neo, Wahoo Kicker, Cycle Opsaris, the Hammer, and so on. And there are a lot of great functionalities for your perfect and motivating and effectively training. You can download training sessions for each level to help to train as it's relevant for you. You can adjust each exercise very simple to your level, depending the resistance or the duration. That helps you also to train effectively. And you can download training sessions with videos and music similar to the indoor cycling spinning sessions in your gym. And music is very good for the motivation. It helps you to ride with the correct cadence. It's very good. And you can ride also your next event or favorite route as a GPX route, also with route videos. That's also a very good possibility to do your indoor training. And also do hard training sessions during the season, for example, a HIIT training. If you don't have very much time, you can do a 40-minute session. That's very helpful. Yeah, so start with us on ictrainer.com in your future of cycling. Thanks for watching, and we'll see us.